is getting broke, it makes all young. Yeah.
Made my bed and I dug my grave. You don't worry what the fuck I say. I saw God to 008, been getting wilder, yeah, to this day. I got no shame in my face. I read threats and I give thanks. And she aiming whatever it take on my name, that's my game. All day going psycho, on top of the Kiko. Man, just trying to go disciple. You just trying to go viral. You trying to build you up an empire. Digging more, you won't revive us. No, dust in the wind, let it blow away. Sun comes out, all the stars gotta go away.
All my heavy chains getting broken. And my weary heart's getting hard. Come exalt your name. Exalt your name. All my prison doors swinging open. Cause the enemy couldn't hold. Come exalt your name. Exalt your name.
Anyway. Sorry, can I listen in? I'm James, sorry.
This is James. I actually didn't ask you his name. What's your name?
Cole.
Cole. Nice to meet you. I'm Josiah.
Yeah. Are we live or something?
Oh, no.
Well, we have a YouTube channel, but... Oh, yeah, I mean, we're just... Sorry, do you mind?
No, not at all.
Cool. Nice. Cool.
You're good.
Well, yeah, man, I don't know what you got into, but we're just here...
I was just asking him about if he agrees with everything in the Bible. And just, like, on the... controversial topic of homosexuality, you know, sure. Regarding believers in the Bible and non-believers, you know what I mean?
So. Yeah, I mean, the Bible makes that clear. A lot of people want to say, you know, well, Jesus never addressed it directly. You know, he never mentioned homosexuality, but with that way of thinking, you would carry that to another, so he never addressed pedophilia either. So then that would therefore make that okay, you know. That's an argument I've heard, you know, it's in Matthew 5. Matthew 5, you know, Jesus talked about marriage, you know, between a man and a woman, that ultimately cuts out every other possibility between a man, and woman, and woman.
Okay.
And then if you look at all throughout the Bible, you see man and woman, you know, you hear about, you know, Sodom and Gomorrah was, you know, destroyed for that very thing. And yeah, and so, you know, the Bible talks a lot about it. Well, enough about it to where it's on the list. And one resounding point is that regardless of what the sin is that you may or may not struggle with, we're all in that same boat of having fallen short of the glory of God. And we're all going to stand before God and answer for the things that we've done. And the greatest thing we could do is give our lives to the one truly who already owns it. And it's the God of the Bible, Jesus Christ, the God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, you know, the Holy Spirit. The greatest thing we can do is look at what the Word of God says in its fullness and believe in it. You know, Jesus said, if you love me, keep my commandments. So if you become a believer, it's following what the Word of God says. From there on, you're coming out of the world, you're obeying God, you're loving his law, you're storing up his commands in your heart so that you wouldn't sin against him. It's a battle every single day between the flesh and the Holy Spirit that isn't a believer. But before you even get to that, like, I don't know if you've asked, but, like, where do you stand with the Bible or the gospel message? Yeah.
I was saying I don't really necessarily consider myself religious, but he said he doesn't either. He's just...
I don't either.
I believe, yeah, right. So, I mean, I guess in more detail... I've been on and off about believing in God and Jesus. Like, I mean, I have Mary here, and, like, I have a religious, like, themed sleeves. Like, I have Ephesians here.
Oh, you know that verse?
Well, that's for my mom.
Ephesians 3:20?
My mom, that's for my mom's birthday, because she has that.
Oh, yeah. Oh, snap.
Can you quote it?
I
can't quote it.
I can't either. I wish I could. That would be so sick if we could. Yeah, study your Bibles, eh?
It's something about God. Appreciate what I don't know. Are you pulling it up?
Yeah. You want to read it?
Now to him who is able to do immeasurably more than all we ask or imagine, according to his power that is at work within us.
Who's him?
Me. God. Jesus.
Capital H. Capitalize that H.
I'm still learning.
Capital H.
Capital H. Oh, okay.
Capital H, him.
Oh.
God, Jesus Christ, God in the flesh.
I didn't know that.
Him. And now the question is, do you have Jesus in your life? Do you have the Holy Spirit?
I mean, I've prayed like the, I pray like a, pretty rarely, occasionally, but that's it.
Josiah, you were talking to this young man for a bit. Why don't you give him the gospel message?
I did, but I'll give it again.
Well, I said, did you like
started
kind of touching on a lot of different things?
Yes, we did. Well, I started with our inability to satisfy God's wrath against our ungodliness because we're sinners. We've broken His commandment. And we don't deserve His grace. We don't deserve anything from God. He's given us life. He's given us breath. He's given us everything. He's given us everything we need to live and survive. And then we go and turn against Him and we break His commandments. But God demonstrated His love. He's a God of righteousness. He's a God of justice. It says in Romans 1 that His wrath,
by
pours out His wrath upon all the unrighteousness of men. His wrath comes from heaven to pour out on all unrighteousness of men.
Mm.
But in the same way, He's a God of love, and He demonstrated His love. God demonstrated His own love for us, and that while we're yet sinners, Christ died for us. So He became Christ, was God manifest. God came to God who created all, became man, became flesh, and dwelt among us. Then He lived a perfect life, a life that we couldn't live. He lived a perfect life and died on the cross. And if we put our faith and trust in Him, if we put a faith and trust in that perfect gift, that perfect transaction, He lived a life we couldn't live. He died to death. Now, He didn't deserve to die, but He died anyway. Because He loved us.
Mm-hmm.
If we put our faith in Him, He will save us. If we confess with our mouth, Jesus is Lord, and believe in our heart that God has raised Him from the dead, we shall be saved. And it says in the book, and I said earlier that death is our punishment. That's our wages. It's what we earn, right? I'm a carpenter. I make money from building things and farming, so all that stuff too. And then I also earned death by sinning. But then He has abolished death and has brought life and immortality to life. The gospel says that in 2 Timothy. So Christ is the one who has abolished death so that we could live eternally. For God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in Him should not perish but have eternal life. And I told you this, and it's a wonderful story. It's the most important thing you could ever, because your life is the most important thing to you. You don't know when you're going to die. You can walk across the street and die. You can go home and die in your sleep. Yes, you got to. It's the most important decision you can ever.
What was your name again?
Cole.
Cole. Could I ask, like, what made you come up?
I just drove by and saw it. Paid the good person test, and I wasn't sure what it was about. So, found out it was
not good.
Holy Bible. Yeah.
We're not so good.
No.
We're not so good after all. You know what we do as humankind? We look to the left and right, and we say, you know, compared to that guy, I'm not that bad. You know, I might have done this, but he did X, Y, Z greater than mine. But again, at the end of the day, we're all in that same boat, and that we have all broken God's commandments.
Mm.
You've broken one. That in James it says it's the same thing as if you break all of them. You stumbled at one point of the law. You stumbled in all of them. So we're no different than anybody else. You know what we need? God's mercy. And His love was demonstrated for us in this. Yet while we were still sinners, Christ died for us. Even though we don't deserve it, we don't deserve heaven, we don't deserve God's mercy. Jesus died for us. He died for you. Your sins are placed on His shoulders. And the only thing that you can do is, He quoted Romans 10:9. Now, if you don't mind, if maybe you can read it. Just so you can, like, comprehend it for a second. Is this?
In pink highlighter?
Yeah.
That if you confess with your mouth Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised Him from the dead, you will be saved.
How do you interpret that? What does that mean to you?
If you
want to read it again. If you want to read it again, you can.
Well, like it says, believe in your heart that God raised Him, this would be Jesus, the Son, mm-hmm. right? From the
yep.
dead, you'll be saved. Obviously, you can confess all you want, or you can, you know, confess with your mouth all you want, but if you don't really believe in it, then it's not the same.
You know, yeah, words are one thing, you know.
Exactly.
I know you say you pray, and that's a great thing. But the question is, like he was saying, you know, we're not religious, but it's a relationship. It's a relationship that you do or you don't have with God. You can't talk to or pray to the God that you don't have a relationship
yeah,
with.
Yeah, right, exactly. Which I guess I do. Because I only pray out of, like, desperation for like, more sins, you know.
Yeah. So now.
Repent, therefore, be converted, that your sins may be blotted out.
And so it seems like in some way you have a conviction about the things that you've done wrong. You know, I don't know your story or background. I don't know if maybe at some point in your life you put your trust in Jesus Christ for salvation. But based off what this verse says, and based off of you just simply stopping, which I think is for a reason, the greatest thing that you could do is put your trust in Jesus Christ for salvation. Based off of what this word says, you know, just like he's saying, one day we're going to die, we're going to stand before God, our sins are on our head, or they're on someone else. You know, when Jesus died, when we believe on him, when we repent of our sin, his righteousness is imputed onto us, or his righteousness is placed upon us. Jesus Christ, his perfection, his everything, his perfectness is placed on us. So it's like when we stand before God, he sees us as forgiven. He sees Jesus standing like next to us and saying, this is, he's mine. He is my son. And so I would ask you, has there ever been a moment in your life where you've gone before the Lord in prayer and said, Lord, please forgive me for my sins. I understand I'm sinful, and I understand that you are the Savior of the world, and I want you to be the God of my life. I believe that you died for my sins and you're risen from the dead. Have you ever prayed any prayer like that? People call that, it's not in this verbatim, but people call that the sinner's prayer. It's where a single prayer, when you put your trust in Christ alone, in that moment, that instance, not just with words, like that said, but when you believe it, when you truly believe that in your heart, and you say it out loud, that's the moment that you receive the Holy Spirit. You got God's everlasting promise that he will never leave you, forsake you, and you're forgiven for everything you've ever done and everything ever will do. Okay. And that's eternal life. That's salvation.
Yeah.
Is there anything in that that doesn't make sense?
Nah, I get it.
So now the only question would be, what would stop you from putting your trust in Christ right now for salvation?
I don't know. Nothing really. Just up to myself, but I want to approach it.
It's a decision.
What decision I want to make, yeah.
You know, why don't we pray for you right now? And if you feel led, you can pray that prayer. If you don't, then we would plead with you that you go home. You go home, you go in your room, you know, whatever you do. You lay down in your bed.
Don't even wait to go home. Leave.
You know what? That's even better.
Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ and thou shalt be saved.
Today is the day for salvation. Today is the day for salvation.
Yeah.
Now,
I thought it's easier said than done.
It is. It is, but
a background where I haven't had a relationship. God. I don't know, like, a long time.
If you want that relationship, bro, his hand is outstretched to you right now. All you have to do is reach out and take a hold of Christ. That's all you have to do. It's like Christmas. There's presents underneath the tree. You go over, they're wrapped up. All you have to do is receive those gifts. It's a free gift of salvation.
Oh.
Would you want to pray right now and receive Christ as your Savior?
I mean, we can pray, but as far as receiving Christ as my Savior, I can't guarantee that.
Let's pray. Let's pray. And then you make that decision. Although, we'll say, it is the greatest decision you can ever make. And don't wait to make it. You could possibly not make it home.
Yeah,
don't wait to make the decision. So if you do want to do that right now, you can. And if you don't, then I'd say the first thing you do when you get home is that. So do you want to pray?
Sure. Dear Lord Jesus Christ, I pray for Mr. Cole. Thank you that he came and stopped here. I pray that I know that it's a divine encounter. He looked over. He didn't have to look over. He saw a sign and he wanted to come and talk. So thank you, Lord Jesus, for that. I pray that he realize the how close we are to death all the time. We're on the precipice of a cliff standing over death. I pray that he realize that. And I thank you for your son, the Lord Jesus Christ. I didn't deserve anything. I'm a sinner, and I'm only saved by your grace. I thank you for him and the Lord Jesus Christ, and that he's the one who's abolished death and brought life and immortality to light through the gospel. And he made ways for salvation that I might overcome death and that Cole might overcome death. I pray that he put his trust in the Lord Jesus Christ. And In your holy and precious worthy name, the name above all other names, the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
And I know it sounds crazy, bro. I know it sounds crazy, like, oh, the gospel message. Oh, it's, and the people are like, oh, the Bible's written by man. The Bible says that you're going to understand. He's going to lead you into all understanding. If you receive the Holy Spirit when you pray that, if you pray that prayer, please, please pray that prayer. And you mean it. God's going to reveal himself to you more and more. And this is just going to make more sense every passing day. And your life's going to change. Your conversations with your friends will change. Your convictions will change. Your understanding and ideas. Your whole world will change. You just have to make that decision. It's a decision that you can make. We can't make it for you. But don't do it just because we're pressing you to. Make it because you want to do it.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Okay. God bless you, bro.
Yeah, you too.
That was nice talking to you.